By the way, don't forget to subscribe to this channel as you're watching this video. Don't forget to give me a shout out on your social media platforms. Share my channel with all your friends, family, lovers, your entanglements, etc. Let me not digress. Let me get back into it. Video content. Back in the day, they used to say the word content is king. This is extremely true. But now on social media platforms or on the digital space, video content is king. Call it the boss. Imagine video content as your silver bullet, for instance. And here is why. Most people are more willing to experience a story, experience a post, experience a lecture visually, mentally, and audibly. You see, it's capturing all the elements about sense. For instance, test may be tricky, but I think if you've tested something, you could still envision it. So video content is that strong because it's encompassing everything that's out there. I can put text, like you're seeing text here. You can hear me, you can see me. Here's a cutback of something I talked about, you get it. This is the power of video content. Now, great thing is in the last video, I shared some stats on internet penetration and data use in Uganda, for example, or in Africa. Here it is again, you can look at it. So this informs you that people can afford data. People are able to stream. People are able to consume your content easily right now because smartphones are a lot more in the world right now in Uganda. And then the telecom providers or the other ISPs are providing a lot more internet at more affordable rates. Personally, I'm Rock Telecom right now. I think they do a very good job. I'm on Airtel when it comes to Telcel and then MTN on my other handset. Chifesi guys, don't come through guys. So anyway, video can be consumed now because it's more affordable. Now let's talk about the dynamics of video. For example, video content works online because it achieves all the previous things that I've said, but short video content is even much better. Small snippets of what you're trying to explain to people. For example, this is a long video, but maybe my trailer is going to be much shorter. Before you came here, probably you saw the trailer because it piqued your interest. If you saw the thumbnail and you are interested in learning about content, for instance. Video content should also be, can easily be used in a repurposing format. For instance, if you're watching a long series, let's say Game of Thrones season 1 to 8 or whatever it is, a recap video can narrate everything in a simple and more refined and summarized way because people are intelligent enough to put one piece together and pick interest to watching the bigger thing. Video content can also sit on almost all social media platforms right now, especially in the new found trend of status, memory, or WhatsApp stories, for example. Let me use that because it's the most common thing. 30-second vids, 1-minute videos on Instagram TV. People want to see the summary of what you're doing, but in a short series of videos. It was very deliberate for them to do that. It's not, they just didn't decide to open up a status feature and say you're going to watch a video for over 5 minutes because people lose interest. Hopefully you guys don't lose interest as you're watching my videos as well, but those are some insights on what content should be. Remember, your content has to be precise, summarized, very attractive. Color is extremely important in content because it picks on those senses in the brain. This thing is very scientific. Social media people, influencers, you're becoming scientists or biologists or neurologists, if that's a word. So yeah, video content will be able to achieve that. So let's talk about some specifics like we did for visual and audio. Your videos are better if they are shorter and more summarized. Here is why. Attention span. Unless you are a very brilliant creator who has amassed a huge following of people on the internet, like KSI, PewDiePie, Corey Kenshin, these are the people that I follow. So unless it's that format where people are yearning for a lot more from you, go for the option of shorter, precise content, especially if you're doing brand communication and a long series of campaigns. If your campaign spans out over 6 months, plan for video content that's going to be broken down throughout the entire week. You get it? It doesn't have to be a long video like back in the day when people used to watch a wedding for 4 hours, a recap of a wedding. It could be in short clips. I see a lot of that on Instagram these days. Another thing about video content is design it for a particular platform. If it's going to be on Instagram, make sure it's landscape. If it's going to go on WhatsApp stories or Instagram stories, make sure it is portrait or the long version-ish thing. If it's going to be on a personal blog or on YouTube or whatever it is, design it based off the consumers that you have on your platform because their data spend dictates on how it's going to be taken in, you get. If they're used to watching your videos for a very long period of time, give them exactly that. Another thing about video content is try and integrate all the elements of design into your video content. Put subtitles, put text in there, put a couple of things in there that are going to help you better narrate this. Your accent could be different from the people that are watching you, or it could even be a scenario whereby you're having a lot of, let's say, things that you're explaining. So put visuals on the side like you're seeing here. Make sure if you're doing recaps, it's there. Be creative with your videos. Do cutaways, do case studies in this, and yeah, this will ensure that you're actually benefiting your viewers. There will be a lot more on my website in that article that I'll put there. I'm not the best writer out there, so it will probably look like a PowerPoint presentation of pointers that you're going to look at. That's been a summary of what content 101 could be so for social media. Remember the key things, like we would summarize it. It has to be precise. It has to be designed for your audience. That's extremely important. If there's anything you will take away from this video, is all the content that you design is specifically for that audience. If it's a website, there's a particular niche website content audience. If it's for Twitter, Twitter has its own content. Even if I'm on Facebook and Twitter, I will consume your content differently because of the mood of that platform, because of the trends on that platform, because of the people that are talking on that platforms. For example, LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter are all different kind of platforms, so you have to treat this content differently. Those that are creating content for brands, there are things that you must attend to. One, your client's business goals. What is a business objective at the end of that day? However much you want to do a very amazing and beautiful piece of content, is it going to make money for your client? Think about that. Two, is it going to be content that's supposed to create engagement? If it's a brand still, look at what Coca-Cola does with its content. The thematic, the wording and the phrasing that they use and the colors, these are attracting consumers to their brand for particular reasons, you get. Another thing that you must consider if you're doing content for brands is, what are the brand elements? How can you tailor them to fit into that type of content? If your brand is red, but it has a hint of yellow inside there, it's not a must that you must pick the red and yellow at the same time. No, think about it critically and say, if the interface of this platform is full white or pitch black, will the red fit in well? Will it be yellow instead? Get it? These things need to be changing, especially for the designers that are out there. Learn to explain the why to your clients, and this will direct your content into fitting or being more suitable. Most of you will say, most of you have experienced a scenario whereby you put up something brilliant, but it gets one like, two likes. It's not because it's a trash video or a trash picture. No, sometimes it's because of the elements that you've instilled in that content that are going to prevent it from blowing up. To get it? Look at what TBWA does for MTN. Trending topics, content that suits in there. Their brand has a very good yellow. For example, MTN usually suits in well with most content ideas because of the simple factor. It's a bright color. It gives you some kind of peace at heart and etc. Shout out to you guys, very good designers. Another thing that you must consider for when creating content for brands is, it must be very consumable. Don't give me a 30-minute video talking about content creation if you haven't planned to put it into two parts, like I've done this video, for instance. I breezed over the beginning parts because they were quite easier and focused more on the most important bit. Same thing. Are you going to deliver a streamed piece of content that is going to stay on the platforms over time, or are you going to pre-record it and make it come off as streamed? Always consider these dynamics. What's the most important thing you put in mind is the end user. Look at what Watoto does. The people that go to pray from there on Sundays get that kind of content. When you're streaming it on TV, it's more or less stayed the same thing. Look at what NBS does. It's going to go and stream something live, but it will maintain the same quality of that pre-recorded kind of content that runs on the TV. So consider all these things. Hopefully you guys have noted down a couple of this stuff. If there's anything more that you wanted me to talk about content in any way, please put it in the comment section below. I'll be very willing to come and put a lot more insight on it. Don't forget to go to my website and check out a couple of more insights on this video. I know it's a very long thing. I try to fix it within 15 minutes, but hey, we've picked this long. Thank you guys for watching my channel. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, comment, sanitize, stay safe. COVID-19 is still a real thing.
Kinda?
Yeah, so just do that. And I like to throw some shout outs at all my friends on my social media platforms, especially Twitter, that always gas me up to do these things. It's very important to share feedback, and I learn a lot from you guys. Like for instance, I'm able to wing these kind of videos because it's something I've practiced over time. And that actually reminds me of one cute insight that you should do is your presentation most times should come off as video content. Forget still, forget text, forget audio. Not because they are bad, but because video content actually achieves that goal much easier. So yeah, see you guys next time. Thank you for watching. We have two more videos to go through in this learning path, and that will be analytics and managing brands online. Hopefully you guys are learning from this series. See you guys next time. Thank you for watching. Peace and love.